You know, it turned out, obviously, like going a goal down, but we obviously come here expecting to get the 3 points. We believed in our ability, we've been working hard in training, but obviously going the goal down as we did, we was pleased to hold out and get the point in the end. So,
a lot of people in the press box are so really appreciated and impressed with your hard work. Is that the type of player you are?
Yeah, I like to drop off, get the ball, obviously, but I'm prepared to put in the hard graft to, you know, help the boys out. You know, I'm not one of those boys, a luxury player. I like to put my fair share in and help the team out.
And this is a great experience for your career, coming here in the Blue Square Premier, having to dig deep?
Oh, definitely. I've been, like, had loan spells before in the past, but I've been in, like, lower divisions, Ryman Division 1, the Ryman Prem, and obviously, like, the Conference South last year as well, but I was really pleased to obviously get the chance to come, because it's only a division below Gillingham are now, and hopefully I'm proving myself, and hopefully that'll help me for my case back at Gills.
And do you believe that Grays can get out of the relegation zone?
Oh, without a doubt, yeah, definitely. The short time I've been here, the boys are showing that, like, they've got a lot of ability, and it's, I think it's been a bit of a difficult time for the club, players coming in and going, but I think this group of boys can definitely get the club out of trouble.
And you're looking forward to Tuesday night now?
Definitely,
against Cambridge?
Yeah, the games are coming thick and fast. It's what I need as well, and I think it'll help the rest of the boys, because obviously the past month's weather hasn't helped, so hopefully you get out of the relegation zone sooner rather than later.
Gary, is that the type of vital point as difference between survival?
I suppose so. I'm disappointed we ain't got three. I'm really disappointed. And I know that maybe that sounds a bit greedy, but I really am. You know, I thought we had probably the better chances second half, although a wee bit of luck went our way when they hit the crossbar and one disallowed for offside. And obviously we've given away a soft goal. Big Steve knows that. But then on the other hand, the goalkeeping, he pulled out an absolute worldie 2 minutes later. So he's had an up and down day today, unfortunately. But I thought we worked tremendously hard at a game. Deserved the equaliser at least, and I thought that was a terrific finish by Andy Pugh. But I am going home a little bit disappointed.
But the players must be very up after getting that point, and these are little things that help the players.
Yeah, they are, but again, I think, I'm not saying things have changed dramatically, but they're actually sitting in there absolutely gutted that they haven't got a win out of that game. And in the last couple of seconds, we had probably two decent chances, and that would have been a lovely little takeaway. But maybe that's a measure of them now, that they're disappointed coming up to Barrow and only getting a one-all draw.
And Andy Pugh, that's two goals, two games. You must be delighted with a player like that.
I'm pleased for Andy. Listen, you know, and we need to get around the games now. And, you know, the match fitness I thought was a bit better than last week, because they got one under their belt, and it'll see us into Tuesday now, a very big game against Cambridge. And it's going to be Tuesday, Saturday all the way through now. So they've got the match fitness under the belt. They needed that one again today, so there's no excuses about fitness or anything like that now. And Andy's got a little touch for scoring goals, and long may it continue.
Are you now putting your own imprint on the team, would you say?
Well, that would be for other people to say, but I'd like to think so. I think our work effort has really improved. I think our pressing is a measure of our game that we have improved on. We've tried to play a lot higher and in the opposition's half more. And if that's me putting my stamp on it, then yeah, perhaps it is.
And you've always been a positive and confidence person, and you said earlier in the week that you think you can get up to mid-table if necessary.
Yeah, certainly. Yeah? I'm not going to change that. You know, and teams like Cambridge will obviously come to us. They're looking for a result for another reason. But, you know, it's no good coming to us and think that we're going to roll over and let them tickle our tongue. We ain't going to do that anymore. We are going to go out and try and win every single game we play. Simple as that.
And it's great to see you after the game as well. The team acknowledging the fans that came to this long journey.
Why shouldn't they too? They, you know, fair play to them. Fantastic. I didn't think we'd have that many up here, and they were great. And giving me some stick today as well, Mr. Gooch, they called me, and Sumo. So I've had some today. But no, I love that, and they should acknowledge him as well. These players, like I said, they're a good bunch of lads as well, and you know, we just got to guide them in the right direction. And little things like that, I think, make a difference. And hope they appreciate it, the supporters, which I'm sure they do, and the players certainly appreciate them being up here, because I thought they were great today.